Thank you for joining our latest Market Moment video. I'm Anthony Valeri, Director of Investment Management in Wealth and Fiduciary Services. Today, we'll talk about investing at all-time highs. There are a few topics that can make investors nervous, as buying at all-time highs and potential fears about riding a wave down. But what we'll show today, buying at all-time highs is actually not a bad time to invest. It's actually a good time to invest, and you can see good investment results. Now, let's get right into it. First, important to know that new all-time highs come in bunches. They're not as rare as you may think. This chart shows the number of all-time record highs in the S&P 500 and its predecessor indices going back to 1954. In 2021 alone, there have been 41 new record highs. And you can see, just looking back over time, there are often many years where you have multiple new highs set. So all-time highs beget additional all-time highs, and they're not that rare. Let's take that concept a little bit further and look at, what are the odds of seeing additional all-time highs if you happen to invest at an all-time high? And in the top part of this table, you see that over 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and a year, the odds are very high that you will see a new all-time record high. 99%, in fact, over the next 6 months. So good probability you'll see a new record high. In the bottom half of this table, we look at, what are the odds of an all-time high, whether you invest at an all-time high or not at an all-time high. And you wouldn't think this would be the case, but if you do invest at an all-time high, you actually are more likely to see additional all-time highs over the subsequent 1 month, 3 month, 6 month periods and 1 year timeframe as well, compared to when not investing at an all-time high. And this takes the average of all occurrences. So it speaks to the fact that momentum can be a powerful force in investing. All right, so we've talked about the probability and likelihood of new all-time highs. What are the investment results when you buy at an all-time high? And here we show the average cumulative gain investing at an all-time high and not at an all-time high. And you can see, going back all the way to 1928, the results are actually fairly strong in both cases. Over the near term, the investment results cumulative gains are fairly similar when investing at an all-time high or not investing at an all-time high. But over the longer term, 5 and 10 years, slightly better invested when you don't invest at an all-time high. And that's fairly intuitive. Over the longer term period, that compounding and buying at a lower price will help. But still, both cases show investment success and make a strong case for investing either way. On the right side of the table, we show the probability of a positive return, whether investing at an all-time high, and again, not investing at an all-time high. And over the near term, fairly similar. It's those outer 5 and 10 year periods where the probabilities are slightly higher. But again, chances of success strong in both cases and shouldn't deter you from investing when the market's at an all-time high. Now, let's look at the downside. Let's say you had rotten luck and happened to invest at the absolute peak of the stock market, just ahead of a recession and a subsequent 20% bear market decline or more. And we go back to, again, to 1928, so almost 100 years worth of data, and we found the 7 periods with the longest time to recuperate your losses. Now, there's no sugarcoating the event of the Great Depression. Took 25 years to recuperate your losses if you invested at the all-time high. Now, the other 6 cases, those also take some time. In the early 70s and at the peak of the dot-com bubble in 2000, it took just over 7 years to recuperate your losses. But in the grander scheme of things, this is not that many occurrences over 100 years of data. Yes, that 7-year wait or even a 5-year wait following the financial crisis in 2008 can seem like a long time. But most investors are investing for a very long horizon, 10 years or more, retirement, 20, 30 years or more, and therefore, this also should not preclude you from investing at all-time highs. There's more than enough time to recoup those losses and see gains over the longer term. Hope this is helpful. Again, we wouldn't discourage investing at an all-time high. The results are good. I'm Anthony Valeri. Thank you for listening, and we'll speak to you again soon.